Hi there, I'm Edwin Palmer.
Welcome to my IQ series.
What is IQ and how is it different than intelligence? That's what I want to find out in this video. So let's start with intelligence. What's that?
As I've told you in an earlier video, intelligence is the capacity for logic, understanding, self-awareness, learning, emotional knowledge, reasoning, planning, creativity, critical thinking, and problem-solving. More generally, we can describe it as the ability to perceive or infer information and retain it as knowledge to be applied toward adaptive behaviors within an environment or context.
In short, intelligence is a mental capacity which enables you to understand and learn things, and then, in a certain situation, you apply what you've learned.
How's that different than IQ? What's IQ? An intelligence quotient, or IQ, is a total score which we get from taking several standardized tests which have been created to assess human intelligence. The psychologist William Stern coined the abbreviation IQ for the German term Intelligenzquotient. It was his term for a scoring method for intelligence tests at the University of Breslau, which he advocated in a book from 1912.
Historically, IQ was a score obtained by dividing a person's mental age score obtained by administering an intelligence test by the person's chronological age, both expressed in terms of years and months. The resulting fraction was multiplied by 100 to obtain the IQ score.
So a person's intelligence quotient meant his or her mental age divided by his or her chronological age times 100. So, for example, if David here performs like a 12-year-old, although he's 7, his IQ would have been 12 divided by 7 times 100, and that equals 171. When psychometricians developed our current IQ tests, they defined the median raw score of the norming sample as IQ 100 and defined each standard deviation score up or down as 15 IQ points greater or less.
By this definition, approximately two-thirds of the population scores are between IQ 85 and IQ 115, about 2.5% of the population scores above 130, and 2.5% below 70. Keep in mind, though, that scores from intelligence tests are estimates of intelligence because we can't get a concrete measure of intelligence given the abstract nature of the concept of intelligence.
Are there factors which influence a person's IQ?
Yes, psychometricians have shown IQ scores to be connected with factors as diseases and mortality, parental social status, and to a substantial degree, biological parental IQ.
While scientists have investigated the heritability of IQ for nearly a century, there is still debate about the significance of heritability estimates and the mechanisms of inheritance. We're moving on. What do we use IQ scores for?
We use IQ scores for educational placement, assessment of intellectual disability, and evaluating job applicants. In research contexts, scientists have studied IQ scores as predictors of job performance and income.
An interesting thing is that raw scores on IQ tests for many populations have been rising at an average rate that scales to 3 IQ points per decade since the early 20th century. This is a phenomenon called the Flynn effect. In conclusion,
Intelligence is a mental capacity which enables us to understand and learn things, and then, in a certain situation, apply our knowledge. In contrast to this, an IQ is a total score, which we get from having taken several standardized tests. These tests have been made to assess our human intelligence. This information came from these websites. You'll find these links below this video. Be sure to subscribe to my channel and watch this series from the start. Next Friday, I'll be back with a new episode in my series on intellectual giftedness. Till then, I only want to say three things. Thank you for watching. Have a great day. And bye, y'all.